To add data to the map, you can click on the Add Data button in the menu. Here you have different choices to add data from a data repository, draw your own data, or use custom features, for example, from a CSV file. And now we're going to pretend that we are a researcher with elephant data in a CSV file. So we click custom features, then we can add new data by clicking on the plus button and selecting CSV. We can choose a file, which I have prepared. These are forest elephants. And you can see a wizard. Here you have to select common CSV information like the delimiter, which is comma separated, and decimal separator, and so on. And then you click next, and now you have to indicate the temporal information, latitude and longitude column, and a spatial reference system. Then you can click next, and now you have to enter time information. In this case, I have an observation date, and I select the time interval that starts at observation date and ends never. So the data is always valid after this point in time. And the column is, of course, the observation column. I click next, and now I can indicate the type of the columns. This is obviously a number column here, so I select number, and then I click next, give it a name, and then I can add it to the system, and it will also appear on the map. I can zoom in, and you can see that the point clusters are dissolving. So now I can see all the points, and the data is also visible here in the list of imported datasets. To get more information on the forest elephants, I want to know how much forest cover or tree cover is at a point of observation. For this, I add another dataset. I click on Add Data, Data Repository, and then I search for forest. And here I can use the global canopy cover for the year 2000. Click on it and you will see the raster dataset also on the map. Now I can close the sitemap and reorder the layer list so that I can see the observation points. I can change the symbology. I will make them red so I can see them more easy. And then I can also see on the map if I drop out the legend that darker green is more forest cover, lesser green, or lighter green is less forest cover. And like one would expect, forest elephants are found in areas with high tree cover.